listening to me. Today, we start work on a new show. You're going to work for 4 weeks and then try out in Atlantic City. You're going to work 12 hours a day, 7 days a week. You're going to work till your feet fall off and you aren't able to stand up. But 5 weeks from now, Pretty Lady is going to be the best thing in show this town's ever seen. You all have your hats, your coats, your dogs, your cats, your canaries, your trunks. So get them aboard. Rehearsal's at 8 o'clock, so let's get moving. Of your lives. Company dismissed.
Company dismissed.
Company dismissed. Are you coming to the party, Mr. Marsh?
What?
To the Regency Club. Miss Jones and Mr. Barry just invited everybody. Something funny?
You are. Look at yourself. Eyes shining like a kid at Christmas. Dreaming of parties and opening nights. The glitter and tinsel of musical comedy.
Sorry.
A speck indistinguishable from the 40 other specks that thus I put there.
I know that, Mr. Marsh. But put all those specks together, you have something alive and beautiful that can reach out to 1,000 people we've never seen before.
Broadway dreams, Sawyer. We've all had them.
Well, I mean to hold on to mine, Mr. Marsh.
So did I. Sweet dreams, kid.
They are. I'm a speck of dust in your show.
Oh, she pushed me! I want her fired!
You little fool! Take your things and get out of here! You're fired! Ladies and gentlemen, Dorothy Brock has had an accident and will not be able to continue with tonight's performance of Pretty Lady. Your tickets will be refunded at the box office. House lights! Sawyer, you're angry at me and I can't blame you. It's not easy being fired.
You did me a favor, Mr. Marsh. It may not have been easy, but I got the message loud and clear. Go back to where you came from, Miss Peggy Sawyer, and that's just what I'm going to do.
Sawyer, I came here to apologize and ask you to come back.
I have a train to catch, Mr. Marsh.
And to take over Dorothy Brock's role in Pretty Lady. She has a broken ankle and she's out of the show. If you can do it, the part's yours.
I'm sorry, Mr. Marsh. Show business isn't for me. I'm going back to Allentown.
What was that word you just said? Allentown? I'm offering you the chance to star in the biggest musical Broadway scene in 20 years! And you say Allentown? Now listen, Sawyer, and listen good. Even if you don't give a hoot about me, think about all the kids you'll be throwing on the street if you don't do this. Think of the songs that will wither and die if you don't get up there and sing them. Think of the costumes never worn, the orchestrations never heard, the scenery never seen. Think of Pretty Lady, the thrill and pleasure it could give to millions. Think of musical comedy, the most glorious words in the English language. Sawyer, think of Broadway for crying out loud. Come on along and listen to Lullaby of Broadway. Lullaby of Broadway. The rumble of a subway train, the rattle of the taxis, the daffodils who entertain at Angelo's and Maxie's. When a Broadway baby says goodnight, it's early in the morning.
Make it mean something like this.
Jim, darling, they didn't tell me you were gonna be here. It was grand of you to come. Now you try.
Jim, darling, they didn't tell me you were going to be here. It was grand of you to come.
No, no, that's impossible. Look, have you ever been in love? Have you ever had a man take you to him and kiss you? Now say the line.
Jim, they didn't tell me you were going to be here. It was grand of you to come.
Again.
Jim, they didn't tell me you were going to be here. It was grand of you to come.
Once more.
Jim, darling, they didn't tell me you were going to be here. It was grand, grand, grand of you to come.
That's it. All right, places for the finale. Benny, I want to talk to you.
Julian, it's 8:40. We've got to call places.
They've waited this long. We can wait one more minute. Now listen and listen hard. 100 people, 100 jobs, $100,000. Blood, grime, and sweat, and it all depends on what you do out there tonight. Oh, I know what you're thinking. Here comes Marsh with another one of his pep talks. Well, this is the last one, so you're gonna come straight from the heart. Our hopes, our futures, our lives are in your hands. So go out there and make them shine with your golden talent. This afternoon it was acting. This one, I mean.
Julian, we've got to begin.
All right, tell him to take the house to half. Sawyer, you're going on that stage a youngster, but you've got to come back a star. And without any mistakes, and without that thing either, Julian Marshall crying out loud, and I say you will.
So I congratulate you.
You're quite a girl, Miss Peggy Sawyer. Quite a girl. And you're on your way to becoming quite a star. You're the million to one shot that comes home a winner. For years to come, thousands of little chorus girls are gonna go to auditions and say to themselves, who knows, I might come out of this another Peggy Sawyer. I only ask you to be the type of star that you would want you to be. Shine your light over this glorious gulch they call 42nd Street. Give it your talent, your strength, your youth. But try, if you can, not to give it all of your heart, because it is a very loving heart and I would hate to see it broken. Now, go along to the Ritz and enjoy yourself.
Good night, Mr. Marsh.
Good night, Allentown. Come and meet those dancing feet on the avenue I'm taking you to. 42nd Street, hear the beat of dancing feet. It's the song I love, the melody of 42nd Street. Little nifties from the 50s, innocent and sweet. Pretty ladies from the 80s who are indiscreet. They're side by side, they're glorified, where the underworld can meet the elite. Naughty, body, gaudy, sporty. 42nd.